Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It is a very happy day because today Nayika reposted my picture and I've been so like all over the world. I don't know how to express it. So I've been getting a lot of requests to do a video about how to blend your eyeshadow, about how to do colorful eyeshadow. So I thought this is the perfect time to do eyeshadow and show how to pack the colors, how to blend, how to make them work. And if you're someone who at all thinks that colorful eyeshadow doesn't suit you or a certain thing doesn't suit you, please take that thought and put it away. That is not the case at all, guys. I feel all these things are just in your head. There's no such thing as this won't suit me. Like, there are so many dark skin people. Like, once go see Juvia's Place, I guess that the Instagram page, you see so many dark skin beauties with such amazing eyeshadow looks, like bright purple, bright blue, bright green. I feel it's just an Indian's head that a little brown skin, that won't suit us. It is not the case. Like, I've been there. Until 2 years ago, I used to think that pink doesn't suit me. Let it be pink lipstick, pink anything pink doesn't suit me. But now, if you see me, I'm always a person who wears a pink lipstick. Let it be new, let it be dark, let it be anything. So yeah, I'm going to show how to do colorful eyeshadow, and I'm going to do green eyeshadow because if you can pull off a green eyeshadow and if you can do a green eyeshadow well, I feel you can pull off anything. So let's get started. So I'm going to use the Morphe palette today. This is the 35B. I guess they just discontinued this now because of the James Charles palette. But you can use any palette which has greens. I'm going to use this set of greens today. So I thought I'll show you how to do your brows as well in the same process, because doing brows is like a major part of putting your whole eyeshadow look together. So my eyebrow starts from here originally, but I just like to pull it to here because I have a lot of gap between my two brows and I kind of don't like that. Just stroke your eyebrows, never draw your eyebrows like a line, because that look very unnatural and it look very ugly. I mean, if you're someone who does it, it's fine. According to me, it's ugly. See how natural and nice that makes your brow look. Just give the strokes. So now let's just clean our brows. I'm directly going in with the concealer and I'll apply it all over my lid, and then I'll take a concealer brush and I'll just clean the brows off also with that. So this is the Maybelline Age Rewind. I'm just going to place concealer all over my lid. You need to use a lighter shade of concealer on your eyes to make any color pop. So this is like 2 to 3 shades lighter than my skin tone. So I use this. This is a really nice concealer. It doesn't crease as well, so I use it. And you don't have to. I'll just get there. So yeah, now I'll just take a sponge and spread that concealer properly on my lids. And the basic key to any eyeshadow, I guess, is like 4 shades. One for the crease, one to blend it, and one for the outer corner, and one shimmer. You can literally, do any eyeshadow with 4 looks, like, the 4 shades. So I'll just use these shades today to show you how to do it. I'll use this shade. I'll even tell you what brushes I use. So I like to personally go in with like a transition color all over my lids because I have a lot of lid space. But if you're someone who likes to have a precise, a rounded shape or a winged shape, you can precisely apply your transition shade and then blend it as well. But I just like to lay all the transition shade around my crease area. So I'm just going to take a brush This is the BH Cosmetics number 5. This is like a fluffy brush. This I bought recently and I'm in love with these brushes. So I'm just going in with this shade. One thing about colorful eyeshadow is like let it be blue, pink, green, whatever. If you want maximum payoff, you need to pack it and then blend it. If you're just going to blend it like a normal brown or normal, you know, a cream eyeshadow, it is not going to work because it kind of takes all the pigment away. So you need to pack and then blend. Oh wow. So yeah, this is the color on the brush. You can see that bright green. If you're a starter, just, you know, bake your face, like bake underneath your eyes and do it so that you don't have any fallout. Or actually, if you're a starter, I would recommend you to do your eyes first. Like it's a whole, you know, huge argument to do your eyes first or your base. But I personally like to do my base first. It's like a personal choice, guys. It's not a big deal. Make sure there are no creases. Now, before I bought this brush, like I literally bought this brush 2 weeks ago, like 2 or 3 weeks ago. Before that, I used to use this brush for my crease. Like this is also a fluffy brush. I used to just lay it and, you know, blend it all over. So this brush is an ordinary brush. I just bought it off Amazon. It's like a bunch of things. Some retailer, some seller was selling it. So you get a bunch of these brushes. You're going to see a lot of ordinary brushes here because I literally have 2 or 3. You know, brushes which have a name, which have a brand. So yeah, like that also works very well. I'll show the other eye with that brush. It's just that if this takes 10 seconds to blend something, that'll take 20 seconds. So you can just make anything work really. Now I'm using the other brush. See, the payoff is same. It's just that you need to blend this a little more and pack on a little more because the brush doesn't pick up so much pigment as the BH one does. Now, so let's go into the second shade. Now I want that to be like, you know, around the lower part of the crease, if that makes sense, where I would have my cut crease end. Like, you know, if I'm going to cut my crease here, I want it above that. So for that, I go in with a more precise brush. I use this brush. This is also BH Cosmetics brush in the number 8. So I'm just going to take this shade and to just blend that thing more and add a little more definition to my lid. Now look down and imagine where your crease will be, like where you'll cut the crease. Now I usually cut this crease, my crease here. If you have a hooded eye, you will obviously have to fake your, you know, lid space or something. Like you need to create a fake crease space. I don't know what to tell that. Like if, like, you know, because people who have hooded eyes, when they open, they can't see anything. So like you just need to place something here where you open and you create a fake lid and the color can still be shown. So I'm just taking this color and packing it on. Even I don't like to go along my crease line for my cut crease because I kind of have really small lip cutting the crease. So I like to go a little above. Like I'll show you how to do that anyway. Eyeshadow is all about placing, blending, packing, because like the color kind of disappears after a point. So you need to keep on building it until it comes to the ideal thing, like, you know, this is going to stay. Now since I'm packing this green, the lower green will kind of disappear, so you need to blend the both together by taking the previous shade again. Now I lay down the green, so I'm going back with the same brush. I'm going to take that shade, the previous shade, and I'm just blending like the sharp edges. I don't want to have like a, you know, a difference where the each color ends. I just want like a gradient shift, like a darker green, a lighter green, so like that. So I'm just going to blend that off. See, like that is the two shades blended. Now what I do is I take a packing brush. This is also a Sheen brush. I bought it in a bunch. I bought it, I guess, around 300 or 400, I don't know. So I'm going to take the same dark green and I'm going to pack it on my outer corner. Because I want more definition here. So see that I packed the color, and while packing I just blended it a little bit. Before going onto your lid, what you do is you pick up the color and you just tap it off so that that excess doesn't fall on your face. Don't be vigorously tapping it off. Just tap like that so that that excess thing comes off. So when you cut your lid, you want the shade above the lid, like the crease, to be a little darker to give it more depth. So I'm just taking a pencil brush. This is also an Amazon brush. These are all a set. The black ones are all a set. That wasn't from Amazon. This is from Amazon. That is from Shein. So I'm just going to take in the pencil brush, tap it, and I'm just going to draw a line where I know I'm going to cut a crease. Always build the color, like, you know, take a little color, pat it, blend it, take another little, take little more, pack it, blend it. If you go into the heavy hand, you can't pack it or, you know, blend it very well, so it's going to look a little weird. So just go in with the light hand first and then work your way through. So yeah, now let's cut the crease. I'm showing the simplest way to create a cut crease, guys, a colorful cut crease. Now till now you know that I've used only two shades. Now let's go in with the concealer. I'm going with the LA Girl Porcelain. You can go in with the same concealer, but I'm going in with this. Now what you do is place the concealer near your eyelid, like, you know, the line of your eyelid where you usually play your liner, and then look up. Now you know where to cut your crease. It's very difficult to explain how to do. It's easier to show. So now, after knowing where my crease is, what I take is I take a little foundation on the concealer brush. This is also an ordinary brush, it came in the same set. So I like my lid to be like, if I close my eyes, like, you can see, right, that lid is still seen, like, you know, it's still lifted and all. So I like my crease, the cut crease, to be that way. You can cut your crease like the whole way, or you can cut it more smaller than this. I like to go in like a little 3/4 distance of my lid, because in the ends I'm going to again blend it with that green. So I just want to have a major part of a glitter as well, or the transition shade, or the cut crease shade. So I'm just going in with the green. I'm going to blend the edges to not have any harsh, you know, edges. Now I'm again going in with the first shade which I used for my, like, the entire crease. I'm just blending all that. Now what I do is, to get more precision, you can totally skip this, but I want more precision for my cut crease. So again I go in with the pointed brush, like the pencil brush, and I go and line the end of that crease to get like a more definition for that crease. So I go in and I deepen that edge a little more. Like, in case you've lost all the dark pigment after cutting the crease because you didn't know where to place that color, you can just do this. Take this, then again go in to the edges and draw the line to show that this is the transition, and then you can go ahead and blend it. Now you can add any kind of color. You can add gold, you can add white, you can add shimmer, you can add whatever. I'm just going to add the white shade they have in the palette, this first shade. For the lower part, like, I just go in with my hand, because colors have a lot of payoff with just fingers. So you can use a brush, but I just like to use my finger for the lower part. And when I need to be more precise, that is when I go in with the brush. And I'm just again taking the green and blending the edges. Now you can easily, you know, just take the same two shades, like what which was in the crease and the deeper shade, to go underneath your lower lash line. But since this is a colorful eyeshadow look, I'm going to do with a different color. So let's just take a blue shadow. I'm going to take this shadow and pack it on the lower lash line. So if you're someone with my eye shape, don't just go with bigger brushes, just pack it in and then just take any small brush, or just don't take the color on the brush, just blend that eyeshadow. You can add any color liner, you can add anything in your waterline. You know what, we'll actually add a little glitter. I'm using the Urban Decay glitter. I'm just going to add this glitter here on the edge of the crease. So yeah, you guys like that glitter? Let's wait for it to dry off. I'll add lashes, liner, and I'll be back. So yeah, the lashes and liner is on. Now let's just highlight the eyebrow bone and the inner corner and we'll be done. So let's go into the same palette. You can use any shadow to highlight. I'm just going to use the yellow one since it is a colorful eyeshadow look, this one. So off camera, I just applied mascara, liner and lashes and a little Sephora crayon long lasting kohl pencil in pure white to my waterline. So yeah. That is the finished look. I hope you guys learned something out of it. And please like, share, and subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. That's it for today. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.